honored to be a part of this. You know, I feel like I wouldn't really be alive in the same way had I not been able to read some of these books that are now banned, and I now get to be the person who gets to expose people for the very first time to young minds, you know, and it's just such an honor to do that, right? You know, you're like, oh, I know it's coming, your mind's gonna explode. And so one of the books that I, you know, that I use a lot is Borderlands La Frontera. This is like the 25th anniversary. And I just recently found out that it was originally a poetry manuscript when it started. And so it became what it was, I think, because the publishers asked if she had any writings. And I think, I don't know, that's the story she told at this conference in San Antonio that I went to. And so, do you have any writings, you know, we could add with the poetry? And so now it's this amazing book that that people still read and you know, find themselves in it. And I know I found myself in it too, in that Spanglish and that in-between world. And, you know, people like Jose Antonio Gurciaga also were poets that I loved reading, and, you know, bell hooks. And so there's so many that I'm just conjuring up as I'm reading. So I'm just gonna do one piece, and as a piece of my own, I'm feeling a little bit weak and tired, so I just wanted to do one little thing, but I'm so honored to be a part of this today. And this one's called Papers o Papeles. Quiéreme mucho, dulce amor mío, como antes siempre te adoraré, y con tus besos y tus caricias, mi sufrimiento acallaré. He always dreamed, so he picked up from his go-nowhere musician situation. She never sat still, and was that fine language on the pillow, country by country, estudiante. He complained gringas don't know how to put themselves together, awful, dongas y flojas. She laughed hard when he said he was a feminist, because he would protect a woman from a beatdown. She just wanted to be friends. He had too many groupies. She always had time for everyone and everything. He liked waiting for her so he could watch her rushing to see him. He spent the night, but he slept in the other room. He'd hoped she'd come back soon and told her he'd come visit her in the US. She thought, that's what everyone says. They wrote letters and postcards because he didn't have a phone. She always thought about the future. He didn't think he had one. She wasn't sure she wanted to go out that night, but her friends thought she needed a break from school, a break from work. His friends thought he needed to go out more after two jobs and night school. She saw him and couldn't believe it. Was that her rockero on the dance floor? He saw her and couldn't believe it. Was that his little estudiante? She taught him to dance as if he was squashing grapes with his toes. It was the first time something good had happened to him in the US. For the first time, she let herself get all desperate and dramatic. 2 weeks passed, and he asked her to be his girlfriend, all formal y la chingada. For the first time, he wanted to be domesticated and thought the moment-to-moment planning might be enough. With love in her heart and justice on her mind, she thought she'd use her birthright to save him, save herself, a ritual, a sacrifice, to show her love was down. She bought her dress at the mall with her dad. He bought his first suit. All present felt the magic in that simple moment. When she saw tears in his eyes, she knew he really loved her. He said he always would, and he used three languages just to make sure. She loves to cuddle all day, but remembers that she has to fill out the paperwork, because the immigration lines just keep getting longer, and there is no line. And then they pay into this system that guarantees nothing, and the lawyers to the Unabomber and 9/11 set off laws that might separate them. It's been 10 years and he wants to see his mama. 10 years and she pretends to keep the hope for both of them. He threatens to go back after all they've spent on lawyering. He says don't sympathize with the situation because he already feels like shit for causing so much trouble. She knows what she did was right, but she still feels wrong. She wonders why she falls apart so easily given all her opportunities. She says, everything will be cool. He says, nothing has been cool since. Es imposible, mi cielo, tan separados vivir. Tan separados.